Hello! Welcome back to our tutorial on the Advanced Part Library in ZWCAD MFG. Last time, we learned how to use the parts in the library and how to customize part sizes based on existing standard parts. Today, we will learn how to add your own parts to the Advanced Part Library. Before starting, we need to know that the library offers two methods for adding parts. You can insert a single drawing file or a folder that contains multiple drawings. When you choose Object from Drawing, the program will set the current drawing as the source file for adding parts to the current library. When you choose Source Folder, you will select a folder as the source file. The program supports inserting multiple views of a part at the same time. To add a part containing multiple views, you need to choose the Source Folder option. Today, we will take a bolt part as an example to show you how to add the head view and 2D side view of a part into the Advanced Part Library. First, we need to draw the part from different views. Let's start with the head view. The head view contains three circles and a hexagon. Since the insertion point of the part is the origin point of the current drawing, we take the origin point as the center of the circle. Then we can draw coordinate axes to make it easier to insert parts. After finishing the drawing, let's set the layers. When adding new parts, we need to set the layers of dimensions and axes. The dimension layer should be named CP_dim_var, and the axis layer should be named CP_axis. The Advanced Part Library uses dimensions as constraints to make all elements parametric. For sizes that will change in the drawing, we need to add dimensions to them. For the head view, we need to add dimensions of three circles and a hexagon. As the variables shown in the end are the diameter of the biggest circle DK and the width of the regular hexagon S. We need to connect other dimensions with these two dimensions through geometric relationships. And all the variables must use capital letters. When adding custom parts, we need to follow some rules, so that the library can recognize the part we created and make it parametric. The library also supports other mathematical formulas besides trigonometric functions. If you have an interest in it, you can email us for more information. Next, we need to use variables or formulas to replace the specific dimensions to make them parametric. In this process, remember to use capital letters. When entering constant numbers, we need to enter unit after the constant number, so that the constant dimension will be scaled to the current unit. For the diameter of the smallest circle, we can use the geometric relationship of trigonometric functions to connect it with the known variable s. So the diameter of the smallest circle is equal to 2 s(tan(30). And should be written as tangent(2 s)(30). After all layers and dimensions are set, we can save the drawing. The drawing can be saved in DWG or DXF format. The rules for the prefix of the drawing name are as shown in the picture on the right. Different view drawings of the same part should be saved in the same folder. Next, let's draw the side view of the bolt. We can use the same method to create the side view. One thing to note is that the parameters between the two drawings can be related to each other. So the variables DK and S we used in the head view can also be used in the side view. When we create the bolt, the chamfer function is also supported. Then we need to set up a hidden layer besides the dimension layer. The hidden layer should be named CP_hidden. Just like the process of creating the head view, we need to assign dimensions to the CP_dim_var layer and change the specific dimensions to variables or formulas. Since we have already shown these steps when creating the head view, we will speed up the specific steps here. After completing these steps, we save the side view in the previous folder and name the file with the prefix 2D_. Then we can start to add this part to the library. Open a new empty drawing and open the Mechanical Standardized Parts library. Click the Define New button, select the Source Folder option, and choose the file folder in which we saved the two view drawings of the bolt. Enter the category name, select Automatic as type. Click OK, and then the new part will be added to the library. We can find the part in the User folder, and the two views of the part can be selected. We can also use the Copy and Edit functions to add new part sizes. Let's add AM6 size of this bolt to the library. We can find the specific values in the picture on the right. The first one is M5, so we can change its name. As you can see, we can insert bolts of not only different views, but also different sizes into the drawing. In addition, you can add parts of different sizes at the same time by modifying the UUC file. First, change the file suffix to .csv and open it. We can see the part dimensions and attributes in the table. Copy an existing row of M5 size and paste it to add new part sizes. As IDB represents the part number and each one has a unique value, we need to change the IDB numbers of other sizes to 0001 and 0002. Next, we can quickly add different part sizes to the table. In this case, we just copy the existing table data into it. After that, set the format of all content as text. Save and close it. Finally, change the file suffix back to .uuc and the setup is completed. Open the Advanced Part Library again. We can see that parts of different sizes have been added to the library. We can insert the 2D view of AM10 bolt into the drawing. That's all for the second part of the tutorial. Stay tuned for more tutorials about ZWCAD MFG.